the best. You can be the King Kong. On Friday, November 7th, the State University of New York at New Paltz hosted the 2014 Women's Volleyball Quarterfinals. Number 6 seed Buffalo State took on number 3 seed Cortland in the opening match. Buffalo State defeated Cortland by a score of 3-1 despite dropping the first set 25-16. The Bengals then rallied and pulled off 3 straight victories to pull off the upset in the first round. Buffalo State was led by Sam Parente, who led the team with 21 kills. Kayla Pitts also finished with 11 kills. Jennifer Cecchettini finished with 29 assists and 13 digs, while Hannah Rinaldo finished with 13 digs. For Cortland, Janine Petora had a team-high 16 kills, while recording 13 digs for the double-double. Melanie McGurk also had 18 digs. Ashley Ruggiero finished with a match-high 28 digs. After defeating the Red Dragons, the Bengals will now play Fredonia on Saturday at 3 p.m. in the semifinals.
I think our mindset and game plan was to play our best volleyball because we haven't really consistently done that in SUNYAC play this year. And we recently just lost to Cortland. They were our last team that we played in regular conference play. So we knew what we did wrong and we knew what they did right, and we were ready. We really practiced against what we didn't do well 2 weeks ago and what we really needed to execute tonight. Yeah, we like this gym. I think it's our lucky gym. but the girls, we're familiar with it. It's a great venue. We also play in a big venue, so I don't think that really scares us at all. But being here last year definitely helps, but it doesn't matter where you play. You got to play your game.
Yeah. I think Fredonia is a really good team. We play them and they swept us, but I think that we have been working really hard, so I think that we have confidence in ourselves, and I think that if we play our game that we can definitely beat them.
I think coming into it they might have a little bit of nerves, and we've already experienced this, so we just need us to take it the next step for the...
Yeah, I can speak for myself and then I'll let the girls answer. We definitely did not play our best volleyball in SUNYAC this year. We learned a lot as a team, and we knew that sixth spot wasn't where we ultimately should be, but we're very fortunate and blessed to be in playoffs, so we know, all right, well, if we're going to start playing really good volleyball, now's the time. You guys want to add to that?
Yeah, I think that even though we're the underdogs, we're still learning. We don't, just because conference play, we still learn from each game. We just learn from Cortland's set, I would say, and I think that we just need to keep pushing, and being the underdog doesn't really matter. It just means that you gotta show them that you shouldn't be there.
It's like we coasted through the season, but now it's putting it full throttle, and that's exactly what we're gonna do.
Like that.
In the evening's second quarterfinal matchup, we saw Oswego, the number 5 seed, against Brockport, the number 4 seed. The Golden Eagles held off some furious comebacks by the Lakers and won in 5 sets 3-2. The Golden Eagles won the first set 25-10 and dropped the next one 26-24, but bounced back and won the next 2 out of 3 sets to take the first round victory. For the Golden Eagles, Kayla Barber led the way with 19 kills, Emily Floor had 12 kills, and Noelle Poloncarz had 50 assists. As a team, Brockport recorded 107 digs, with Jamie Snyder leading the way with 29, Emily Floor with 23, and Kayla Barber with 21 digs respectively. For Oswego, Olivia Zimmerman had 25 assists, while Lauren Edwards also dished out 17 assists. Jessica Long led the team with 11 kills, while Megan Roffs and Kelsey Dillon also finished with 10 kills. Brockport will now take on host New Paltz tomorrow at 6 p.m. in the semifinals.
Just super excited for our program that here we are in the semifinals of our conference championships. a year later. So really proud of all the work that our whole entire program has done to get to this place and how hard they fought. So they definitely earned it.
I thought our offense was very consistent, and when we made errors, we shook them off and just kept being aggressive and hitting the ball and tipping when necessary and looking at the court. And Jamie as libero helped out with that by talking to our hitters. I think that we had some really good defense that set up our setter and our hitters, and we all worked really well together and talked to each other and keep each other up positive and work to the next ball every time. I think that we all work really hard to get to the ball and get stopped before the hitter hits, and so that helps a lot so we can move right away. And also, we work and practice a lot about getting outside the block and seeing the hitter and seeing their tendencies. So we set ourselves up pretty good to be in the general area of the ball, and I think that helped a lot.
I thought our zone one defense improved from the beginning of the match to the end, both with our setter and our DS. That helped. And then I thought our outsides, especially Emily Floor, dug some really great balls in that 5-4 seam tonight that they typically have scored on. And so that was huge for us. Their middle scored pretty well and their right side. So that's something we're gonna reevaluate tonight and see how we can be better for that one and defensively tomorrow. It's gonna take an entire team effort. We're gonna have to play a great game plan and be very aggressive offensively and from the service line. They're also a tough serving team, so it's an opponent that we've just got to have a mindset that it's gonna be a battle, and we're gonna try and make it a match that is just ugly and just make it a fight tomorrow. And just see how much grit we can put out there, because if it's a clean match, they're pretty good in system, and that's going to be a tough battle for us if they're in system a lot.